Call 911. I have a suicide.
We have a suicide at the San Francisco Assistance Center.
Put down the gun. Put it down.
When lives...
Somebody help me!
Don't do this. I didn't rape you.
...are on the line.
Put down the gun. Keep talking.
They are the ones... ...to answer the cry for help. Crisis Center, Friday on NBC.
In a crisis.
San Francisco Assistance Center, can I help you?
There is an instant.
I'm gonna kill myself.
John, can we talk about this?
Between life and death. Before a hospital can be called.
We have a responsibility to everyone who walks through those doors.
Before the police have a case. Witness the lives of a courageous crew.
We have to believe that what we do matters.
The lives they touch.
Leaving is the hardest thing to do.
And the lives that touch them. Crisis Center premieres Friday on NBC.
Any plans for the weekend?
Other than a psychology paper and about a semester's worth of reading to catch up on, not much.
This is Lester. His mother will be by right after work to get him. And we're all finished with spray paints, aren't we?
Hey, I'm an artist.
You're a vandal. See you on Monday.
Bye. You want to watch TV?
All right, come on.
What are we now, daycare?
Yeah, hey, I owe you a Friday night, Kath.
You already owed me for two.
Come on.
Lights off, please.
Made of money.
I pulled strings to get you into the 30-day program. I even got your insurance to cover it, and what do? You go AWOL.
Man, I thought we were friends, you know?
What?
Now, come on, tell me how you're feeling about this.
Rick! Rick, what are you doing?
He jumped me!
You're the doctor!
Night, darling.
San Francisco Assistance Center, this is Kathy. Can I help you?
You okay?
Yeah, sorry.
Lance! Nando, grab him! Whoa! Lance!
Dr. Buckley's with a patient right now. Can I take a message? What's your name?
John.
Sit down.
John? And where are you, John? Are you at home?
Just... I can't take it anymore. There's no way I'm gonna kill myself.
John, can we talk about this? John, I want to help you. Call 911. I am so sorry.
I just wanted to be over.
Listen to me. I need you to do two things right now. I need you to put down the gun, and I need you to tell me where you are,
John. We have a suicide caller on the line at the San Francisco Assistance Center. Male.
John, where are you?
Hold on. We're trying to get a location now.
Okay, and where's the gun?
In my hand.
All right, John.
She's working on it.
I want you to tell me about it. I want you to talk to me.
I feel so bad.
It's okay to feel bad. It's okay. Look, I know we can work this out. Doesn't have to be this way, John. We can work this out.
Oh, she can't get the location.
John, just talk to me. Just put down the gun for 3 minutes, okay? Put it down. No, John, just talk to me for 3 minutes, please. John, tell me about him.
Vic.
Okay? Tell me about your father. John, stay with me. John, don't. No, don't. No, he won't. Please, talk to me. Keep talking.
Kathy.
You had your pet.
What?
Oh, my God.
John. John.
love.
Thanks for bringing breakfast.
Do you know what that Lamhart...
Where are we with these Martinez kids?
Looks like the mother's going to do serious time. And surprise, no one seems to be able to locate the father or fathers.
Foster parents seem okay. I made a home visit. Nice people. They keep their kids in school. Anybody got dibs on this chocolate donut?
Well, not now.
My trainer says our biggest enemy is saturated fat.
Wow, lovely enemy.
All right, what's going on with this homeless case? I still don't understand why we just don't 5150.
Well, he's not gravely disabled, a danger to himself or to others. Isn't that the legal definition of a 5150?
I believe so.
He's been cited several times for public nuisance.
He has night terrors and he cries too loud in his sleep.
It's for his own good, Rick.
Well, this is about self-determination, about how he wants to live. His name is Larry, by the way.
I'm looking at citations that are going to turn into a warrant pretty damn fast. All I'm trying to do is get this guy, get Larry to someplace safe.
Sorry, I'm late.
He's there next jail priority.
Late? You early? I thought you was coming back for a while.
So what's next?
Look, I know I have a couple of weeks of catching up to do, but I'm back here because I'm ready to work, so... If anyone has a problem with that, just come talk to me.
I think Nando's rehab group is waiting for the conference room, so...
Yeah, thanks.
Meeting adjourned. Welcome back.
Thanks. So you didn't tell him I was coming back, did you?
Well, I didn't want to set any expectations in case you changed your mind.
I told you, I'm fine. That's why I came back.
Yeah, Dr. Tolman said you've been dealing with it pretty well.
Yeah, she's great, but I'm fine.
Good, good. Keep up the sessions, though. They're important, you
Rick,
know?
You're making me feel like a client.
Hey, we're all clients sooner or later. Now, go make yourself useful. Tess is trying to get a mailing out.
Okay.
She shouldn't be back here so soon. She's still in the middle of her own crisis.
She's seeing a therapist, and I'll be watching. When she falls, I catch her. Human safety net, okay?
We have a responsibility to everyone who walks through those doors, Rick.
Yeah, we have a responsibility to her, too.
You haven't missed much around here. And Nando changed his dissertation topic again, like we care. Marilyn is thinking of going a little blonder, which I advise against, by the way. Other than that, it's been really slow. Not that much to do at all. Don't you have spring break in a couple of weeks?
Tess, I hope you're better than this in court.
Too obvious, huh?
Don't worry about me. I just want things to get back to normal, okay?
Shouldn't be opening any case.
We're here to help people, right? Well, helping people helps her right now. We get her a few wins, we get her confidence back. She's on her way to getting over this.
And what if she loses?
I know we're not married, but I gotta have some kind of rights, don't I?
You do, Brian. You have rights. Now I need to ask you.
Mind if I join you?
Brian, this is Dr. Rick Buckley, co-director of the center. Brian has a custody problem.
Look, I need a lawyer, not a doctor.
I'll introduce you to her in a second, but first I have to ask you a few questions. Are you sure that this is your baby?
Yeah, it's my baby. Okay. Look, she knows I wanted to raise it, and that was cool with her until about 2 days ago. And now she won't even talk to me. I mean, she gets crazy every time I'm near her, and... I mean, the baby's due in 3 weeks, and if I don't find some help, she's going to give it away to strangers.
Excuse me for interrupting, but could you join me in the alley for a moment?
Be right back.
Okay. Take your time. All right, so the last time you tried to talk to her, she didn't say anything to you?
Look, are we going to talk to a lawyer or not?
Yeah.
Hey, Serpico, how's the arm?
Ready by Saturday, coach.
Oh, good. I don't want to lose to those sissy fire boys because our best pitcher's on the bench. What's in here?
We found him off the tip of a van behind the Lincoln Hotel.
Ooh. Hooker Central.
Yeah, well, the same guy who called us called Channel 4, too. So now we got news crews waiting for us at the station, and I didn't think it was a good idea to take them down there in their present condition, if you know what I mean.
Hi. My name is Dr. Rick, and we're going to take care of you here for a little while, so why don't you just hop on out of there and go...
You don't speak English.
Get her to sign this paper, and you can walk out of the hospital with your baby.
Yeah, but I told you, she won't even talk to me.
Well, then we're going to have to go to court. Are you ready for that?
Look, my father skipped out on me before I was even born, okay? That's not going to happen to my kid.
Ryan, how old are you?
I'm 19.
You got a job?
Part-time. Look, I know I'm young, but that's my baby. I mean, I got a boy name, and I got a girl name, and I got a crib waiting in my apartment. She can't do this to me.
Okay. Just step up here. You can have a seat right there. And I'm going to give you this form. Take your time.
Yeah, I don't believe it.
Look, guys,
we can't help you because you can't help yourself.
That's the problem.
Why are there naked girls in your office?
I have been waiting for that question my whole life. Gary thinks they're part of a child prostitution ring out of Asia.
Why didn't Gary call child welfare services?
Backed up, 6 to 8 hours for a caseworker.
They're gonna need some clothes.
It's just where I was headed. Can I help you?
I'm here to see someone in charge. That would be her.
Hi, Lily Gannon. I'm co-director of the center here. Welcome. Why don't we talk in my office?
Thank you.
Marilyn's told me all about you. Quite the philanthropist.
Excuse me?
Well, your contributions are well known throughout the community, Mr. Saxon.
My name's not Saxon, it's Weber. Thomas Weber. My son Johnny, he called here before.
Mr. Weber, I'm terribly sorry. We are all just terribly sorry.
Yeah. You run this place?
Yes, along with Dr. Buckley.
He's the shrink.
He's a psychiatrist, and I'm a licensed clinical social worker with a master's in social welfare.
He was the one that was on the phone with Johnny?
Mr. Weber, would you excuse me for just a moment? I'd like one of my colleagues to join us.
Of course.
I wish I could say this was going to be easy, Brian.
We'll do everything we can, Tess.
We're just about finished. It's important. Excuse me, guys.
So we'll be here for you either way, but it's your decision about going to court.
Oh, I don't want this thing to get crazy. It's just that I'd do anything for this kid, you know? I mean, she knows that.
We should get her to come in for counseling, I think.
No, she'd never come to a place like this. Maybe if you went down and talked to her, though.
Ryan, I can't promise you anything.
Yeah, I'm used to that.
Where can I find her?
She works part-time at a flower stand at the foot of market.
Okay. I'll see what I can do.
Hey.
Hey, I didn't know you were back.
First day.
Well, we missed you last week. Right field's not the same without you.
Oh, you mean somebody actually caught the ball.
I gotta get back to the station right now, but maybe after Saturday's game we could, you know, catch up.
Look, maybe.
We've been through a lot in the last 2 weeks. All I'm asking for
one of these
is
days, you're going to say yes.
We're here to help
maybe
you the way we can, Mr. Weber, but there's a certain confidentiality that we have to respect.
Look, my son is dead, and all I want to do is talk to the doctor that heard his voice for the last time. Now, don't my family and I deserve some kind of respect, too?
Absolutely. Of course you do, but please understand that we can't violate that confidentiality. This is not a good time.
I was the one on the phone with your son. I think it's important for you to know what he said to me that night.
You're a doctor?
No, Miss Duke.
Kathy, I think you should let
her
us...
a kid, for God's sake. She's a kid.
She is a merit-based casework intern.
I thought my son was in the hands
college
of a professional.
Yes, I can assure you that Kathy has had the...
What did you say to him? What did you do?
I didn't do anything.
I came here to find out why my son is dead.
Mr.
Now
Weber,
I know.
You can't calm down.
It's your fault.
You
John's dead because you picked up the phone.
Weber,
you didn't know what you were doing.
Enough.
I'm sorry.
You tell that to my wife.
You had no business telling Weber who you were. It was completely out of line.
I thought I was helping him.
That's the problem. You're not thinking straight. You've come back too soon.
How long would you have taken?
Look, I've been doing this for 12 years. You've been here for 12 months? Now, I'm not saying that any of this is your fault. But having someone suicide on you is a life-changing experience. One that some people never get over. No matter how long they've been doing it.
You don't think I belong here, do you?
Not now.
Kathy.
Okay.
Three turkey, three PB&J.
Pastrami egg roll.
On the house.
Not bad. Hey, when's your dad coming back?
Tomorrow. He and Ma went to Miami for my cousin's bar mitzvah. Oh, yeah. Check these out. We made them for the party.
You don't have to speak Chinese, do you?
I can say happy birthday and where's the bathroom?
Yeah. Not gonna help me. Confucius say, call your mother.
Ma's trying to get us on Rabbi Shankman's catering list.
Yeah, you'll be a hit. I gotta go.
Kathy. Put your shirts.
Hey, Kathy, hold up. Wait.
I never should have been on that phone.
John did not want help, Kathy. He wanted a witness, okay? He and I talked a few times the last month. I tried to get him to come in. He never would.
Doesn't change what I did, Rick.
You didn't do anything. We can't save them all, Kathy. It took me a long time to realize that, too, and sometimes I still can't sleep at night. But we have to believe that what we do matters, that if just one person walks out of there better off, then we're making a difference.
I acted unprofessionally. I never should have talked to Mr. Weber.
Is that what Lily thinks?
Rick, she is my supervisor, too. I can't just ignore what she thinks.
Okay, no, I'm not asking you to. Just use your own judgment, okay? You're good at this. People trust you. I trust you. Now, I want you to give it another chance. I mean, what good's it gonna do Brian and his baby if you walk away now?
Stacy?
Yeah?
My name is Kathy Goodman. Could I talk to you for a second?
Do I know you?
I work at the assistance center, and someone came to me with a problem today. I thought you might be able to help.
Uh-huh. Brian sent you, didn't he?
I think if you let him explain what he wants to do...
I don't believe this.
He just wants to talk to you about the baby.
No.
Look, Stacy, he's the father, and he has rights. I just thought it would be better if you guys talked before he starts any legal proceedings.
He has a lawyer?
Someone at the center's helping him.
You don't know anything about this, and neither does he.
Then why don't you tell me?
Because nothing can help the baby now. And if Brian finds out, he's just gonna blame me.
Blame you for what? Stacy, whatever it is, you don't have to handle this alone.
I don't know. Could be delusional. Could be a simple case.
Hey.
Hey.
Well, I just got off the phone with the county licensing board. Tom Weber's attorney has just filed a negligence complaint against us.
Wait a minute, against us or against Kathy?
What's the difference?
There's a difference.
Guys, can we get on the same side here? Because there's a meeting scheduled for 10 tomorrow morning to review this case. And we don't.
Wait, 10 o'clock tomorrow morning.
Yep, they move fast when they want to. Now, I'm going to spend the next 16 hours coming up with precedents we can cite in our favor. I suggest that you two go through Kathy's history here at the center and come up with a profile that makes her look like Joan of Arc.
But this is ridiculous. They can't sue. Kathy's been through all the training. She knew exactly what she was doing.
We can convince them of that. This all goes away.
And if we can't?
Well, we are still under the probationary period for a new community organization. They could suspend our contract, cut off our funding. Worst case, they could suspend your licenses, too.
So what'd she say? I mean, if you talk to her, it must be good news, right?
It's more complicated than that. Brian, the baby has spina bifida. It's a disease of the spinal cord, and the chances are it'll be born severely handicapped. I'm sorry.
God.
Stacy's coming to the center tomorrow to talk to our doctor. I think she'd be there. You guys have to discuss your options together.
What are you talking about? What options? Well, you think this is going to make me change my mind?
Brian, raising a handicapped child is not an easy thing.
Yeah, you're right. Now, you think someone's going to want to really adopt my kid? I'm the only one this baby's got left now. Don't you get it?
Yes, but you have to think about this. Everything changes now.
So you're not going to help me, huh?
I'm trying to help both of you. Look, just come tomorrow and talk to Dr. Wade. See what he has to say, okay?
I thought you were on my side.
I am.
Sure. Look, I'm just going to do this myself, okay? Thanks for all your help. I'm not abandoning my kid, all right?
David, there is nowhere for them to go.
Don't worry. Marilyn's got it all figured out.
Somebody ought to make that woman president. Twice in one day.
I just came to talk to Tess about a custody case.
Already gone.
Is there a problem?
The baby has spina bifida, and that's why the mother won't let Brian have it.
Well, what'd you tell him to do?
Transportation has arrived.
Oh, great. Okay, let's go, girls. Come on, come on, come on, come on. You too.
Okay.
Follow me.
Bye. Listen, Kathy, I don't think it's appropriate for you to be handling Brian's situation with Weber's lawsuit hanging over our heads.
What lawsuit?
He didn't tell you yet.
Let's go, 1, 2, 3. Limo tonight, riding in style.
When were you going to tell me about this lawsuit, before or after the center got shut down?
Should we wait?
I'm coming, just a second. How can I have confidence in myself when you don't even think I can handle something like this? I mean, at least Lily respects me enough to tell me the truth.
Are you coming, dear?
Yeah, I'm coming. You once told me that this is about solving other people's problems, not proving myself to anyone.
Yeah.
Then please stop making me prove myself to you.
Sorry. You said you were going to tell her.
I should have, but I couldn't. Now she thinks you respect her more than I do. Maybe she's right.
You're just going to sit there whining all night? And you're going to help me put this case together for Kathy.
I knew you'd get off your broom sooner or later.
Marilyn's great. She'll bring the kids back first thing in the morning.
Good. So. Guess you need to get home, huh?
Yeah, I guess. I'm kind of hungry.
I know a good spot. I thought about law school after college, but it didn't seem to fit. My dad was a cop. So was his. Seemed kind of natural.
You know, I like you better without your uniform on.
I don't do that on the first date.
I mean that I think we have more in common than you're not carrying a gun.
I don't know. I think we have a lot in common anyway.
You do?
Yeah, and we live in the same city.
Yeah.
We play on the same softball team.
Yeah.
And we both put our work before anything else.
You make that sound bad.
I've been on the force almost 5 years. I've seen a lot of things and been in a lot of situations that most people my age haven't. Sometimes it's hard to find someone who understands.
Yeah.
you ever killed anyone?
No.
I had a father look me in the eyes today and tell me that he doesn't have a son anymore because of me.
You believe that?
You know what I was thinking about when he said that? How he must have felt the day he brought his baby son home from the hospital. I'm sorry, I keep thinking that if I don't let it get to me, it'll just go away.
Is that what you tell other people?
No.
You know, I always wanted to be in the rap. Casinos, champagne, Angie Dickinson.
Spell that name for me again.
K-A-L-I-N-O-S-K-I. And I'm going to name my kids Sammy, Frank, and Dino, even if they're girls. What do you think of that?
I think we've done our homework.
Me too. Why don't you leave that for tomorrow?
Kathy has a really good record. The rest is up to the board.
Great. Let's dance.
Very funny.
Oh, come on, come on. It's a great song. Could be our last night here.
Oh, don't even joke like that.
They won't close us down. We worked too hard to get it on its feet.
Oh, sorry.
You remember Vegas?
I remember shooting craps with you for about 10 minutes and losing my rent money.
I told you to move in with me.
Don't go there.
You miss me, you know you do.
We agreed.
We agreed that we shouldn't, not that we wouldn't.
We agreed to keep it professional.
Why is it feeling so personal?
You need to get some sleep before tomorrow.
I can't change the way I feel, Lil. Can you?
Good luck tomorrow.
And how would you describe the client volume at the center, Dr. Buckley? A low, medium, high?
High. I would say high.
So the center has multiple problems. Low-income clients, a high percentage of which are walk-in and crisis cases, and a fairly small permanent staff with only one licensed psychiatrist on the premises.
There's always a trained professional there to consult, whether it's psychological, legal, or medical.
And why is my son dead?
Mr. Weber, you've been warned before. This is not the time or place for accusations.
Is it the opinion of the center that Ms. Goodman was fully prepared to handle a life and death situation on her own?
She complied with every rule.
Look, we have provided an entire stack of cases proving Ms. Goodman's abilities. And I would have no problem placing her in the same situation again. She is compassionate. She is intelligent. Do you have any idea how hard it is to find an intern at her age, willing to volunteer virtually all of her free time for no personal gain? Look, I'll tell you what. If after reading through all of these cases, you still feel that we have made an error in judgment, then go ahead. Shut us down. Because she is exactly the kind of person that we are about.
Feel that tightening?
Yeah.
That is a mild contraction.
3 centimeters dilated. So we're finished here. I want you to go straight to the maternity unit, St. Luke's, and I'll set you up with someone good.
I'm glad you came.
Hi.
Hi.
Mom.
My friend owns a boutique on Maiden Lane. She opened early for us.
I pray for sons.
Now, I think both of you should know, most spina bifida patients can expect to live very full lives.
Yeah, from wheelchairs and hospital beds.
Look, I want to hear what he has to say, okay?
Okay. There's a hole in your baby's back where the spinal cord is exposed. The degree of handicap and paralysis is determined by where the hole is
Look,
located.
Doctor, will my kid walk like other kids?
Probably not.
Will it play in a park? Will it climb a tree? Will it ride a bike?
There's no way to tell.
Yeah, so what do you think the chances of all those things happening are if it's raised by a single mother with no college education and no health insurance, or a single father?
What, so you just want to give it away? I mean, let it get raised in some institution where with nobody around who cares?
I thought you said there's families who want handicapped babies.
What? I can't believe this! You're helping her give my child away, aren't you?
No.
Okay, I have to get back to the hospital. I want you on a couch with your feet up until you can get to St. Luke's. She needs to stay as relaxed as possible. I'm out of here.
Yeah, I'll make sure she rests. Thank you, Malcolm.
Sorry, it's an emergency.
Brian, will you meet us up front, okay?
The board saw no grounds to proceed with the lawsuit. Looks like we're off the hook.
Didn't want to gloat.
Excuse me for a second. Relieved.
Yes.
They gave us total absolution, which means there can't be any further investigation.
You're so lucky.
And Weber's furious. You know, I feel for him. You know, he's going to need help to get over this, but he's so angry, nobody can get near him.
I was really worried.
Well, I know you were.
You know, sometimes I wish I could be more like you.
Yeah, and then you come to your senses, right?
Look, you've lived with this for a while, but Brian hasn't. Let him make his own decision, but don't shut him out. I think you guys can help each other through this, okay? Lily, this is Stacy. She has some questions about handicapped adoption.
Right. Hi, Stacy.
She needs to rest.
Lily, again.
Sure.
Have a seat.
It was a little bit.
Sure, but I think this guy's your pimp.
You don't hop on
what?
With your fun.
I've seen a lot of hookers and pimps, but they don't usually get along this nice.
Why are they is getting along?
I have no idea.
Mr. Weber.
If they won't close you down, I will.
Mr. Weber,
stay away from me.
Get everybody out of here.
Stacy's water just broke. Got it.
No calls! Back. If they won't let me take you to court, then we're gonna hold court right here.
Gotta get him to a hospital. I don't want to lose them both.
Back. Okay.
All right. Here you go.
I promise you, if you let the others get out of here, you and I can stay here as long as you want. We can talk about what happened to Joe.
What happened? I know what happened. You people filled his head with so much crap, he didn't know what he was doing.
John came to us for help.
Hell of a job you did, Buckley. See, I know who you are. What you do to people. People you don't even know. Families you destroy because you went to some fancy school and you think you know all about other people's problems, but you're the problem. You're the damn problem, Doctor. You and all the...
Who's on the phone?
What are you trying to do? Get off the phone!
She's having the baby on. She's having the baby.
I said no calls!
All right, all right. Nobody's breaking your rules. You're in charge. Just tell me what you want.
I want someone to pay for what happened to my son.
Okay. All right. You're angry. You want somebody to blame. I'll pay. Shoot me. You know, that'll make you feel better. But, you know, better yet. How about one of them? You know, you kill somebody else's kid, that'll even the score.
I need water and towels and an emergency kit. And I need her help for a minute.
All right. Go ahead. No talking. Anybody.
How is she? She's having the baby. I need your cell phone.
You're no right getting into our business. He was always going to somebody else when he should have been bringing his problems home. You have no respect for family. You should have sent him back to us.
He's 27 years old.
He was a kid. He never could handle much on his own.
And he was manic depressive.
What do you know? What do you know? What do any of you know about my son? You wait! I want to see that.
Kelly? I have to go. Breathe, you know what I mean? Don't push. This is the San Francisco Assistance Center. We have a hostage situation, and there's a man with a gun, and we have a woman having a baby right now. Okay, I need instructions. Okay, heart rate. I need heart rate.
So you're blaming us. You think what we do is harmful. You think that if you had been on the phone with him that night, that you could have saved.
He wasn't sick. He had problems. I told him what to do. Why didn't he listen to me?
Okay. It's under 100.
Okay. It's gonna be okay.
The umbilical cord
may be
wrapped around the baby's neck,
okay.
And we have to deliver it. Otherwise, the baby will lose too much oxygen. All right. Okay.
Okay.
So what would you like?
Of course, you're missing John. It's probably the biggest loss of your life. So let's deal with that.
Let's get everybody here, and you and I. Who called the cops? Who called them? Who? When he was a kid, he always made me so proud of him. He loved science. He used to tell me he was going to be an astronaut. What did I do?
Stacy, stay with us. Stay with us.
Because I didn't listen to him. I didn't love him enough.
just a girl. But they both need medical attention right away. There's an ambulance waiting outside. I wanted to know what John said to me that night on the phone. He said he wished he could be as strong as you are. He knew that one day you'd understand. He wanted you to know how much he loved you. You were a good father, Mr. Weber. But sometimes, even if you think you're doing everything right, it turns out wrong. Please don't make this any more wrong than it already is.
Checking him into a hospital unit
Come
rather
on.
Than booking
oh.
him at the station.
Here. Let's go into the house.
You have the right to speak.
He's right. He did it. So did you.
Excuse us.
Go to Miami for a week and we miss everything.
Dad says that there's 20 different dialects from the mainland alone, but he's going to try to translate.
Good, they're in here.
Home tonight. Any interest?
Nothing but dog day afternoon. I'm sorry about last night. It's always been easier for me to say no than yes.
Hey, you guys, check this out. We asked these kids what they do for this guy, right? Acrobats, not prostitutes. This guy's a trainer, and they brought him out here to try out for the circus. So, they're working out the gym behind the Lincoln Hotel, right? Somebody steals all their clothes when in the showers. Turns out, it's the Flying Falconis, their chief competition.
Is she?
Stable. They're gonna operate in the morning.
The doctor told me you signed the adoption papers.
I love my daughter.
I know you do. And this is the best way for her. I think you did the right thing, Brian.
You know, I heard what you said to that guy. I wanted to be a father so bad. Sometimes wanting it just isn't enough. And when I saw you holding her in your arms, I realized that she was more important than me.
We tried to arrange for an open adoption. It's where the birth parents still have a relationship with their child.
Stacy agreed to that?
She loves her just as much as you do. You know, I only had my dad. But this baby has the chance to have four parents looking out for her. It'd be nice if they got along.
I'm not really sure it's good for the client.
It's not right for us to refuse if they ask for it.
We can't make that kind of decision for somebody else.
I'm sure we can afford it.
Hey, Kath, break this tie. Client comes in, asks for a cup of coffee. Do you want from Kath or decaf?
Slow day, huh?
No, I'm serious. What do you think?
I drink tea. Hey.
Hey.
Figured you'd take the day off.
I'm a workaholic.
That's funny, so am I.
Oh, any news on Mr. Weber?
A psychiatric watch at University Hospital, and his family's with him. And I told the cops nobody wanted to press charges. Hey, you know I never needed you to prove anything to me, right?
Maybe I just needed to prove it to myself.
Get to work, would you?
Hey, can I help you?
I'm here to take a blood test.
Okay. Have a seat right here. My name is Kathy Richards.
Kyle.
Kyle. I have a cousin named Kyle. So I'm just going to ask you a few questions, and then we'll go back there and get you started, okay?
Okay.